Hi, Pisces. Thank you for being here with me. I'm going to shuffle the cards. Two more times. And we'll see what messages spirits have for you today. What's in your energy? Spirits, what does Pisces need to know? All right, Pisces, let's see what's showing up. Okay, wow, the very first card is death. I don't remember ever seeing the very first card being death for Pisces. This is Scorpio energy. It's like you're walking into a new dimension, into a completely new chapter of your life. I'm almost hearing there's no going back. Things are not going to be the same again. Pisces, what does Pisces need to know? This is a complete transformation. Look at this. Look at you moving. You're moving on from what used to be. Good or bad, what used to be is over. You're moving on, Pisces. Look at what you're moving towards, the Ten of Pentacles. Something in your life is completed and it's time for you to move into the next chapter of your life. You could be dealing with a Leo. We have strength here. What is going on? Center card of your reading is the Four of Wands. So you're exactly where you're supposed to be right now at this time in your life, Pisces. You're on track. This moving into this new place in your life. Someone's getting a new house. So that's not for everyone, but someone is. Ten of Wands. Seven of Pentacles. The World and the Fool, Aries energy. Okay, there's no going back from here. From this point, there's no turning around and going back and living a certain way that you were living. It's all changing. And yes, it is kind of sad. But I feel like what's ahead of you down the road, this new chapter, is very exciting, Pisces. So let's clarify and find out what's going on here. It's like you're moving here, you're taking action. Knight of Cups, Six of Pentacles. Something where you may have been looking at things through rose-colored glasses in the past is being revealed to you with the sun. You're finding happiness in taking off the rose-colored glasses and seeing the reality that you're in. It's a complete transformation, complete change. So let's see what's going on. This is an interesting reading that's showing up today. It's almost like usually the chapters in our life are kind of foggy as we drift from one chapter to another, but I'm seeing like something just changing like before your eyes. So let's see what this is. Why is death here? This is something that you don't have a lot of control over, Pisces. It's just something that is going to happen. It's divine timing. Yeah, and there is some sadness here that lingers over what was. You may feel like you're sitting on your own little island here. You have a lot of love to give. And you may feel a sense of loneliness in this place where you are right now, like something's missing. But spirits want you to know. We have 11-11, 11-11, and I'm hearing twos. You may be seeing twos, like repeating numbers. Ones, twos, or threes. But you're being led, you're being taken to a different place, someplace where you're supposed to be. Why is the Six of Swords here? You might be dealing with a Capricorn, but the Devil in your energy is, you're leaving them behind, whoever, whatever this is. And it's like this person is watching you. There's someone watching you move away. And if this isn't someone, this is something that I feel like there's some type of a lesson here that you've learned where you're moving away from the Devil energy, something that you felt attached to. Why is the Ten of Pentacles here? Ten of Swords. The Ace of Pentacles. And the Five of Swords. We have the King and the Queen of Cups. Oh. There you are on the bottom of the deck. You're in hermit mode, Pisces. You might be dealing with a Virgo or a Cancer, but you're the one in control and you're literally pushing forward. There's no need to stay in this hermit mode any longer. It's time for you to move on. And I feel like you're ready to make this move, Pisces, because you know what's ahead of you down the road now. We have the Ten of Pentacles, so it's your legacy. It's a place where you're supposed to be, a feeling of completion. And I'm seeing something new happening, almost will be right in front of your eyes if it hasn't happened already, because it's like you're standing up from a position where life has thrown a lot of swords into your back. And so you've been healing, you've been in hermit mode, and now you're ready to stand up and fight and walk away from what no longer serves you, which is why you're moving towards this Ace of Pentacles, this brand new beginning. There's a gateway for you to walk through here, and it's like you're reaching the end of the road on something where you're going to be crossing into this beautiful place on the other side. Huh. It's very interesting. And then we have Strength. Why is Strength here? This is telling me you've been through a lot in the past, Pisces. And so your inner strength is incredible. Sun, strong Leo energy here. You could have a child who's a Leo for someone. But it's telling me that the spirits are telling me here that you're going to a place where you don't have to be so strong anymore. I see things getting easier for you. The sun is the happiest card in the tarot deck. And so there's a lot of happiness coming into your energy. It's almost like you can move into la-la land for a little while. And it's perfectly okay. You deserve it. I'm seeing someone new coming into your life that gives you this feeling of, you know, like in hermit mode. I kind of feel like you were just fixed on some type of goal, something that you were moving towards. And there's a new door opening up that you're walking through with a new person, a gateway here. You can see a gateway here. This could even be marriage or something. It's a huge celebration. There's a soul connection here, someone that you were meant to meet on this journey that you're on. Why is the Four of Wands here? The Three of Cups. The Ten of Wands. Yeah, there's someone new coming into your life. Very attractive, fiery energy here. Someone who's a free spirit with the Fool. Very attractive. Very nice looking, attractive person. Because see, it's this energy here with the Ten of Wands where I feel like you've been in this hermit mode and you've gotten used to doing everything on your own and you've kind of had your head down fixed on where you're going. But someone's arriving here, Pisces. And you don't even see them coming. Look at this person arriving in your energy. Because you've reached a 10 here. So this energy of carrying everything by yourself is coming to an end. And you're going to be, there's going to be a celebration with the Four of Wands. Something big. Again, this is a celebration. Three of Cups. This could be someone that you meet when you're at a gathering with other people. This is someone that you'll be laughing and talking to. It's like not a major event where this starts off, but it starts off as small. Like I see you not seeing this person even coming. This is someone that you're going to meet when you're not even looking. Why is the Ten of Wands here? Yeah, see? You're very focused on being a hermit, working on what you're working on, your goals. Very heavy, burdened with something, and your energy is heavy. Seven of Wands. You could even feel like you're in hermit mode. You're not looking for love. You got two different shoes on. It's like your complete focus is completely focused on what you're doing, where you're trying to get to, and you're not willing to let it go. You're not willing to lift up your head and look around. Hermit mode, again, I keep hearing that. It's like, I've got to do this. But just while you're doing that, holding on to this that you're carrying around by yourself, holding on too tightly, someone's coming towards you. This person might be an Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius, but this is someone who can be, it can be someone who's very serious and knows what they want. They don't take no for an answer. They jump through any obstacles to get to what they want. But this is also someone that's going to make you laugh and is going to be a lot of fun to be around, that you're going to feel very comfortable with. This person's going to feel natural to come into your life. You're not going to feel defensive or anything. It's going to feel very comfortable and natural to have this person come into your life. And then we have the Seven of Pentacles. Why is the Seven of Pentacles here? Queen of Wands. Two of Swords. And the Eight of Wands. Yeah, see this energy here, Pisces, of being a hermit. The hermit is showing up again. And being closed off in your thoughts, in your truth, walking down your own journey, carrying your lantern, knowing where you're going is coming to a close. I feel like there's been a pause in the energy for you for quite some time. You could be single for quite some time now, but there's an energy moving towards you very quickly. It's like you're looking over at yourself because you've been closed off like this with your arms across your chest, guarding your heart. You may not have even realized you were doing it. And sitting outside of your emotions, the water is your emotions. You're stepped outside of your emotions. And you're coming into this beautiful energy of the Queen of Wands where you are starting to look around, take the blindfold off and look around. Instead of having your head down, I gotta do this. Whatever this is, I gotta do it. I'm not looking up. I'm not looking at nothing else. You're coming out of it and looking around and looking very beautiful as you do. You're starting to put energy and time into yourself now and accepting this new world, this new place. This new place where you've stepped through. Because there's a cycle completely ending. And this cycle has to do with you being in hermit mode. And I feel like there's a devil from the past. Someone that had addictions. Could be a Capricorn. Could be any sign. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. But some type of person from the past. This is like codependency. You didn't just feel attached to this person felt very attached to you too, and this person still hasn't let go. I'm seeing this person watching you step through this new chapter. See, look at this, Pisces. Ace of Cups. It's like you're in your mind stuck, repeating thoughts, repeating things over and over and over again in your mind and looking down. And there's this hand coming out of the sky, which is blessings. It's saying, look, take off the blindfold and look at where you're at. Because you're literally walking through a new gateway. Why is the Ace of Cups here? Justice is here for you. This is Libra energy. This is the scales being balanced out. This is blessings. Who is the Fool? Why is the Fool here? Okay. I actually feel like and I keep hearing it, that you guys are in this Nine of Pentacles energy where you are perfectly fine by yourself. You're single, focused on what you're working on, and there's a Tenth Pentacle coming into your energy here. There's a person that you're supposed to be with, that's supposed to be on this new journey that you've walked into with you. This person's coming into the energy. Why is the Ten of Pentacles here? Yeah, Page of Wands. This person definitely has air in their chart. Seeing you getting communication from this person, and this is someone that could be at a distance from you, Pisces. I feel like this person doesn't live near you. I feel like this person, there's distance. Why is the Three of Wands and the Ace of Swords here? The Hangman. This Pisces energy. See, this is having an epiphany moment, a realization. It's like you've been in this Hangman energy. And there's a new ship arriving here, Pisces. This new ship brings in this epiphany moment, this realization with the Ace of Swords. And it literally takes you out of this Hangman energy where I feel like there's not much that's been happening in love, but love is coming in. Why is the Knight of Cups here? Look at that. The Knight of Cups again. This is new love. Who is this person, though? I want to know who this person is. I want to get, like, a something. I'm seeing someone who has air in their chart. Charming person. Who is this person, spirits? How will Pisces know this person? The Eight of Swords. How will Pisces know this person? There's that Six of Pentacles again. Why is this Ace of Swords here? I kind of feel like you need to come out of this energy of being stuck in your mind and blindfolded, Pisces, and repeating things. Because there's someone else definitely showing up in your energy. But I'm seeing, you know, this energy coming off of you where you're blindfolded. Why is the Seven of Cups here? Keep getting this, like you don't see this energy around you or coming in. Why is the Seven of Cups here? The Three of Swords. Because you're holding on to, you're like in a self-imposed imprisonment of your mind, holding on to something from the past that has caused you a lot of heartbreak, a lot of pain, which is the Devil, holding on to this. Why is the Six of Pentacles here? Temperance is here, Sagittarius energy. Okay, so there's new love coming into your life, Pisces. And I feel like this is someone that you're not going to see coming in, like I told you. It's the energy is going to come in very quickly. I see you here that you're focused on your work. You're focused on what you're working on right now. And there's still like this cloudiness surrounding an energy from the past, you know, that's been slow to move away. See, Justice, the Ace of Cups. There's the Sun again. Yes, new love, the Page of Cups. This person's very, very charming, very nice looking, very exciting. They could be younger than you. They have a very sweet way about them, Pisces. And I'm seeing someone at a distance here. So, and that's going to be different for everyone since this is a general reading. I'm not picking up like a very specific, too much more specific than that, but seeing a younger type of energy, someone who's fun. Your hard work is paying off. New moon in Capricorn. Work through your fears, new moon in Scorpio, and adjustments are required, third quarter moon. And on the bottom of the deck, bring love into the situation, because there's love trying to come in, but you're so blindfolded here, working on what you're working on, but I'm seeing you coming out of it, Pisces. It's like you're moving into this Queen of Wands energy and taking the blindfold off now. It's time to take the blindfold off. You've been in this healing energy for quite a while. But I love you guys. Thank you for being here with me. And thank you guys for liking, subscribing, and all you guys do for me. And I will see you tomorrow, Pisces. Namaste.